Welcome to this model. In this presentation, let us have an insight of reflector antennas. Reflectors are widely used to modify the radiation pattern of a radiation element. For example, the backward radiation from an antenna may be eliminated with a plane sheet reflector of large enough dimensions. In the more general case, a beam of predetermined characteristics may be produced by means of a large suitably shaped and eliminated reflector surface. And the characteristics of antennas with sheet reflectors and their equivalents are shown in this figure. So several types of reflector types are shown here. And the first figure shows the large flat sheet reflector near a linear dipole antenna to reduce the backward radiation. With a small spacing between the antennas and the sheet, this arrangement also yields a substantial gain in the forward radiation. The desirable properties of the sheet reflector may be largely preserved with the reflector reduced in size. That is shown in this second figure. Even in the limiting case, for example, in the third figure, here the sheet has degenerated into thin reflector element. Whereas the properties of large sheet are relatively insensitive to small frequency changes. And the thin reflector element is highly sensitive to frequency changes. The case of lambda by 2 antenna with the parasitic reflector element will be in a different case. With two flat sheets intersecting at an angle alpha less than 180 degree, that is shown in the fourth figure, that is this one, and a sharper radiation pattern than from a flat sheet reflector can be obtained. So this arrangement is called an active corner reflector antenna. Is more practical where the apparatus of 1 or 2 lambda are convenient size. A corner reflector without an exciting antenna can be used as a passive reflector. That is shown in this figure. And it can target for radar waves. This application, the aperture may be of many wavelengths and the corner angle is always 90 degree. The reflectors with this angle have the property that an instant wave is reflected back toward its source, that is shown in this sixth figure, the corner acting as a retro reflector. When it is feasible to build antennas with aperture of mini lens, parabolic reflectors can be used to provide high directional antennas. A parabolic reflector is shown in this figure, and this parabola reflects the waves originating from the source at the focus into a parallel beam. The parabola transforming the curved wavefront from the feed antenna the focus into a plane wavefront. Many other shapes of reflectors can be employed for special applications. For instance, with the antenna at one focus, the elliptical reflector, that is this elliptical reflector, produces a diverging beam with all reflected waves passing through the second focus of the ellipse. And the examples of the reflectors of other shapes are hyperbolic antenna and circular reflectors. The plane sheet reflector, the corner reflector, and the parabolic reflectors are more important, and the feed systems, aperture blockage, aperture efficiency, diffraction, and surface irregularities will also consider these factors. So, now let us have a look into the plane sheet reflector. The problem of an antenna at a distance S from the perfectly conducting plane sheet reflector of finite extent can be handled by method of images. And in this method, the reflector is replaced by an image of the antenna at a distance 2S from the antenna. This situation is identical with the horizontal antenna above the ground. If the antenna is a lambda by 2 dipole, this is in turn reduces the problem of W8JK antenna. Assuming zero reflector losses, the gain in field intensity of a lambda by 2 dipole antenna at a distance S from the infinite plane reflector can be given as GF of phi is equal to 2 into square root of R11 plus RL divided by R11 plus RL minus R12. So this is the method of images. An image is considered at the same distance from the antenna, that is 2S distance. Right. And the gain can be expressed expressed relative to lambda by antenna in free space with the same power input. The field patterns of lambda by 2 antennas at distances is equal to lambda by 4 and lambda by 8 and lambda by 16 can be shown in this figure. That is, and the gain of a function, the gain as a function of the spacing S can be represented as antenna loss resistance with the RL is equal to 0, 1 and 5 ohms. And the corner reflector, two flat reflecting sheets intersecting at an angle or corner forms the effective directional antennas. When the corner angle is 90, the sheet intersects at right angles, and a corner reflector with an angle 180 degree is equivalent to flat sheet reflector. So in 1938, while analyzing the radiation from a dipole parallel to and closely spaced from a flat reflecting sheet, the author, that is John D. Cross, who discovered this antenna, he realized that when the sheet is replaced by its image, the dipole and its image form a WHJK array. So when the flat sheet is folded into square, and square corner, the theory calls for three images, and his calculations showed correspondingly higher gain. So he developed the corner reflector as an extension of his analysis of the WHJK array. He immediately constructed several corner reflectors to obtain the experimental confirmation. The John D. Cross tried parallel wire grid reflectors, modifying both spacing and length of the reflecting wires to determine the limiting dimensions required. And the design of when you come for the design of the corner reflector, two flat reflecting sheets intersecting at an angle or corner forms this antenna. When the corner angle is 90 degree, the sheet intersects at right angles, forming a square corner reflector. Corner angles both greater than and less than 90 degree can be used, although there are practical disadvantages of angle less than 90 degree. A corner reflector with alpha is equal to 180 is equivalent to the flat sheet reflector and may be considered as a limiting case of the corner reflector. Okay, assuming perfectly conducting reflecting sheet of infinite extent, the method of images can also be applied here also to analyze the corner reflector antenna of angles alpha is equal to 180 by n, where n is any positive integer. This method of handling corners is well known as electrostatics, and corner angles of 180 degree, that is flat sheet, and 90 degree and 60 degree. It can be treated in this way also. So corner reflectors of intermediate angles cannot be determined by this method, but can be interpolated approximately from the others. So in the analysis of the 90 degree corner reflector, there are three image elements, 2 and 3 and 4. That is, you can show in this, you can see in this figure. The driven element 1 and the image 3, three images have currents of equal magnitude. The phase of the currents in 1 and 4 is the same. The phase of the currents in 2 and 4 are the same. 2 and 3 are the same. But 180 degree out of phase with respect to the currents in 1 and 4. All elements are assumed to be lambda by 2 long. The figure shows the patterns of square wave reflector for a spacing of 0.5 lambda, 1 lambda and 1.5 lambda. The spacing between the antenna and the reflector. So at the point P, at a large distance D from the antenna, the electric field intensity can be written as, that is E is equal to 2k I1 into cos of SR cos phi minus cos of SR into sin phi, where I1 is the current in each element and SR is the spacing of each element from the corner. That will be given by 2 pi into S by lambda, where k is the constant involving the distance d. The value of EMF, the EMF V1 at the terminals at the center of the driven element is given by V1 is equal to the I1 into Z11 plus I1 into R1L plus I1 into Z14 minus 2 I1 into Z12, where Z11 is the self-impedance of the driven element and R1L is the equivalent loss resistance of driven element. Z12 is the mutual impedance of elements 1 and 4, 2, and Z14 is the mutual impedance of elements 1 and 4. So I1 will be given as, we know that P is equal to I squared R. So I1 will be equal to square root of P divided by R11 plus R1L plus R14 minus 2R12. The field intensity at this point P at a distance d from the driven element lambda by 2 element, the reflector removed will be given as K into square root of P by R11 plus R1L. So dividing this equation, we'll get the gain as G is equal to E of I by E square of phi. That is given by 2 into square root of R11 plus R1L divided by R11 plus R1L plus R14 minus 2R12 into cos of SR cos phi minus cos of SR sin phi. Now let us consider the parabolic reflector. So the diagram shows the different parabolic reflectors. The distance from any point P on the parabolic curve is called as focus. It is equal to the perpendicular distance to a fixed line called the directrix. And the surface generated by the revolution of parabola around its axis is called paraboloid or parabola of revolution. If an isotropic is placed at the focus of the paraboloidal reflector, the portion A of the source radiation that is intercepted by the paraboloid is reflected as a plane wave circular cross section, provided that the reflector surface deviates from true parabolic surface by no more than small fraction of length. And referring to this figure, and the parabolic curve may be defined as follows. The distance from any point P on the parabolic curve to a fixed point is focus, as said earlier. Therefore, PF is equal to PQ and PS is equal to QS minus PQ. Thus, a property of a parabolic reflector is that all waves from an isotropic source at the focus that are reflected from the parabola arrive at a line AA dash with the equal phase. The image of the focus is the directrix, and the reflected field along the line AA dash appears as though it originated at the directrix as a plane wave. The plane BB dash at which the reflector is cut off is called aperture plane. A cylindrical parabola converts a cylindrical wave radiated by an in-phase line source at the focus into a plane wave at the aperture, or a paraboloid of revolution converts a spherical wave from isotropic source at the focus. And confining this, confining our attention to a very single wave or wave path, the paraboloid has the property of directing or collimating radiation from the focus into a beam parallel to the axis. Thank you.